Hello, this time I will show you how to make two simple but very sensitive EMF electromagnetic field detectors. Let me introduce a PCB manufacturer for you, PCB Gogo, our sponsor for this video. Now everyone can enjoy free PCB prototyping on PCB Gogo. If you are an electronic hobbyist or a student, this chance is suitable for you. It's now totally free for 1 to 2 layers FR4 PCB within 100 plus 100 mm. PCB Gogo is a quick turn PCB prototype manufacturer from China over 10 years in PCB industry. They offer FR4 board, Rogers, copper, flex and rigid flex for PCB prototype and assembly service. Their PCB prototypes are reliable and affordable, certified by UL, HOHS. Click the first link in the description and upload your Gerber file. PCB Gogo free PCB activity is ongoing. Electromagnetic fields are a combination of invisible electric and magnetic fields of force. They are generated by many devices like power lines, kitchen appliances, mobile phones, computers, but they are also generated by natural phenomena like the Earth's magnetic field. Many such projects can be found on the internet, but most often the only proof of their sensitivity and functionality is the text in the description of the project itself. So I decided to make two devices, one with discrete elements, transistor, and other with an integrated circuit, and test their features and that are shown in the video. First, let's analyze this device made with 4 transistors connected in cascade form. It consists 4 NPN transistors, 4 resistors and 1 LED diode. This is the schematic diagram. The overall gain is a product of individual gain of each transistor. The last transistor is connected to a LED diode that signals the presence of static electricity or EMF. In fact, this device is not an EMF detector, but a static electricity detector known as electroscope. Specifically, this is an electronic electroscope. A thin aluminium plate is used as the antenna and the device is powered by a 9-volt battery. Battery is secured with double-sided adhesive tape. Let's see how the device works in reality and how sensitive it is. We get a static charge by rubbing a plastic object from the substrate. As you can see, the electroscope responds well to this type of charge. In contrast, the EMF detector does not respond to static electricity. And now let's test this device near a weakly changing electromagnetic field. In this case, we have to move the detector very close to the source of the EMF to light the LED. Thank you. Next, let's analyze this device, which is extremely simple to make. It contains only one 4017 decade counter integrated circuit, resistor and LED signaling diode. This is the schematic diagram. The output of the counter IC shifts from output 0 to output 9 for each positive edge of the pulse received at clock input pin 14. The clock input of 4017 integrated circuit has very high sensitivity and a small pulsating signal can provide an input clock for the counter. When the probe comes near to a current carrying conductor, an EMF induced in the probe due to the magnetic field around the conductor. This EMF gives the signal to the clock input. As the LED has attached to the one of the 10 output of the IC, the LED flashes one for a for 10 clock pulse inputs. Hence, in a normal 50 Hz supply, the LED flashes at a rate of 5 times per second. The sensitivity of the circuit will vary with the length and the shape of the antenna. In this case, it is also a thin aluminum plate. Now let's see how this device works in reality. Let's bring the detector closer to a weak electromagnetic field. A signal for a detected EMF field is the flashing of the LED with a frequency 10 times lower than that of the electromagnetic field. If the LED is continuously on or off, then there is no EMF presence. The sensitivity of this detector is incredibly high, considering that this is an extremely simple electronic device. For example, it detects the field of this heater at distance of 30 to 50 centimeters and more. Finally, I would like to mention that this device can also be used as lightning detectors and a large antenna should be used for greater sensitivity. We can also find them under the name ghost detectors. In one of my previous videos, you can see three more similar devices used as lightning detectors. And now let's follow the way of making these devices. Thank you.